Hey everybody, it's the Poltergeist 5000 back for Metroid Prime 2. Don't worry, this is not 5 seconds after the previous episode. This is the next day. In the last episode, we fought the Grapple Guardian and got the last Dark Torvus Temple key. And in this episode, we're gonna head into the Dark Torvus Temple. And I'm not gonna bother that guy. Just let me through. Thank you. It's creepy that there's an eye there, like one of those sentinel crystals. Although I forget that I keep forgetting that those sentinel crystals are all transmitting to Yumos. Because you'd think that the ones in Dark Torvus Bog. Yeah, the ones in Dark Torvus Bog, you'd think they would be transmitting to, like, the leader of the AUGH or something, you know? Assuming they even have a leader. I don't know. Maybe they don't even have a leader. Maybe they're transmitting to Dark Samus. That would be scary. There's a restock station here. One of the few ammo restock stations in the entire game. They're actually useful in this game because, you know, sometimes it's a pain in the ass keeping track of both your beam ammos. I go into a morph ball, I come out of a morph ball, I like unfurl, there's that animation, but if you cross under something here, then you unfurl instantly, and I don't know why that happens. Maybe because you wouldn't be able to see the animation? Anyway, is there a back here? Keycode acknowledged, final lock deactivated, you may now access the temple. Oh, I could have come in here like any time. Hey, you know what? Isn't there I think there's an E-tank back here. Yup, there's been an E-tank back here that I could have gotten, like, basically. Actually, I'm not sure when I could have gotten this. I think I could have gotten this as soon as I had super missiles. Because I needed the super missiles to get over here. You don't need the keys to actually enter this area. You only need the keys to actually take this elevator. Which we're going to do. I can't scan that. Now, fun fact, okay, the last time I played through this game on, like, on GameCube, when I made it to this point, what I actually did was I came into the visors and I turned down the helmet opacity and the visor opacity all the way down. And what that does is it completely removes the HUD, except for the crosshair. And I fought the entire boss like this. And this is one of the longest bosses in the game. So that can actually be kind of frisky business. I mean, actually, this is not one of the longest boss. It's certainly a hell of a lot longer than the first boss, but I don't know if it's the longest boss. The third boss is also pretty long. The final boss isn't as long as this or the third boss, but it is harder, obviously. I mean, it's the final boss. The final boss in this game is actually pretty tough. I have a good deal of respect for it. Anyway, I hope you're ready for some cool music. Oh, wait, first we gotta scan this thing. Object scan complete. Target is a cocoon. A field of dark energy is disrupting deep scanning ability, unable to scan bioform within cocoon. Energy you didn't need the bioform within signs of extreme growth present in the cocoon structure.
Yeah, the fact is really fucking big. Yeah, what tipped you off?
Organic structure designed to support you. Support will release cocoon. I think you want to do a seeker missile here. I don't know if you need to, but I'm just going to assume that you do. Because we have that power, we might as well. Oh, boy. Oh, there's the door back there. I wonder if it would be possible to get up there somehow. Like, what would happen if you jumped up there? Like, even with hacks, would you be able to, like, leave this boss fight? Because that door isn't locked. Man, you can see Samus' eyes so clearly. Alright, here we go. Whoa! Oh, you know what I was gonna do, actually? I was gonna turn the volume down on the, oh, shit. Whoa! Hi! I was gonna turn the volume down. I was gonna turn the volume down. I'm like, jeez, man, where the hell did you guys even come from? Dark Shredder. I was gonna turn the volume down on my TV so that it doesn't echo. There we go. I love this music, by the way. This is the Chykka. I haven't scanned it yet, but that's what this boss is called. It's called the Chykka. Dark Shredder. Darkly possessed flying platform. It's the same thing from before, except now with the Grain Grumps versus intro. Ow. Okay. So if we could get a scan on this guy, that would be much. Oh jeez, he's jumping. I actually don't know if this thing's sex. This thing might be. I mean, I don't fucking know.
Recording to logbook. Chykka larva, infant insectoid guardian. Vulnerable area detected. Target has a soft underbelly. Adjusting lockdown point to take advantage of this.
Yeah, clever. Okay, where are those? Where are you guys? Yeah, like, where did you come? Where did you even come from? Oh my god! Yeah, this isn't so hard, honestly. Ah, damn it. You gotta be really on the ball with that super missile if you want it to hit before it falls back under the water where you came from. Man! Ow. Okay, should I turn... How long do we go before I turn the visor back on? This song gets remixed a lot, I notice. But all the every remix I've ever heard of this song misses part of the main melody. Because, like, the melody is made up of two instrument parts. I mean, okay, not quite the melody, but more like the rhythm, the backing or something. That part that goes bam on it bam. You know, that's made up of two parts. There's one part going bam 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 bam, and then there's another part going bo do do bo do do bo do do. But every remix I've ever heard of this song forgets one of those two parts. Oh my god, wow, you really gotta be quick on the draw there. Like, the remix in AM2R only has the, and it sounds so incomplete without both. Okay, I'm switching over to the light beam. There we go. Yeah, you pretty much have to switch over to the light beam for this guy. Because it just shoots so much quicker. You're not gonna land a shot with the with the super missile unless you lead it like before the Chykka larva even jumps out of the water or the acid, the poison. Oh, you're coming out now. Okay, yeah. Now you can pull out the... Make sure you dodge this tongue. Oh, shit. Ah, get away from me! Oh, I actually got it. You actually got away from me. How nice of you. Yeah, I just love this. Like, this fight is probably gonna take the entire video. It's that long. Eh? You gonna go for another one? This would be easier if I had the, if I had my visor, because I'd be able to reference the radar and see where it was about to appear. This thing also, the only reason I feel comfortable doing this is because this boss doesn't do enough damage. Ah. What the hand, man? Frick. Oh my god, why did, are you immune to the are you immune to the greatest blast of all? Hang on. I need to check my, I don't know how much damage that that just did. Okay, we're fine. I'm turning it back up. I haven't been hit by that very many times, so I don't have a good reference point for how much damage it does. Yeah, I'm turning it back off. I'm live dangerous. If you're quick, you can actually hit. Oh, I think I actually did hit it there. Okay, go for a second leap. I didn't see how much HP it had left. Damn it! Oi, oi, oi. What am I doing? Turn your visor back on. I don't care if you're gonna get a great thumbnail. You're still not gonna get a great thumbnail because the freaking crosshair is still gonna be there. Okay, you're coming up on the side now. Yeah. Oh, you know what I just realized? I think you actually want to use the dark beam here this isn't the dark Chykka. This is the light Chykka. This thing is actually going to like oscillate between the two forms. Where the hell? Oh my god, hi! Jeez! Yeah, this thing is actually going to oscillate semi-regularly between light and dark as you fight it. Right now it's just the Chykka larva. That means it's weak to the dark beam. Of course, the dark beam is significantly harder to hit it with because the dark beam has no homing ability. Man, oh my god, the stereo was all out of whack. I can't figure out, like, where you're... Oh, god. Okay, there we go. There's that. That's the end of the Chykka larva. Now, here's where things start to get tricky. Yeah, the entire arena splits into three. And the acid goes down? That's peculiar. What happened? Did someone set us up the bomb? Oh, god! Wait, so is this, like, a different creature? Or is this, like, the same thing that evolved? Because it looked like... I didn't see it turn in. I wasn't paying attention. Okay, this is the Chykka. This is just the... Oh, stop. Ugh. This is just the Chykka. Flying Insect Guardian. This light creature can be stunned, especially by dark energy. Well stunned, look for weak spots to target. Yeah, I still can't see, like... Oh god, I'm never gonna be able to hit this thing with the fucking dark beam. What the hell? Okay, so basically you wanna try and shoot this thing in its butt. And just kind of ow. Just try to hit it in its butt. Oh, there we go. Once you've stunned it, start charging your missiles, because you have to destroy its wings. And that's gonna cause it to actually no? Okay, not yet. Whoa! Okay. Oh, this is so cool. I love the freeform movement you get in the Wii version. I mean, I always loved... I mean, I could get used to the movement in the original version, too. But nothing beats the ability to, like, you know, jump straight, you know, do all that shit simultaneously that you get with more freeform... movement. Are you gonna like do something, or are you just gonna be? Are you just gonna sit there and be a dumbass? Yeah, the power beam honestly tends to work better for this. Uh. Boom! Okay, is that... Are we in... Okay, here we go, here we go. Now things are going to complicate themselves again, because now it's fallen into the acid, and when it emerges... What's this? Why can't I scan this? Platform pieces are scanned, and separation systems and flotation systems are functioning in an erratic fashion. Oh, jeez. Now... It's the Dark Chykka. Morphology, Dark Chykka. Dark energy charged flying guardian. Target is charged with dark energy. Most of its body is immune to damage, save for the lower egg sac. Avoids attack by targets, offspring, swarms. You see, how weird is that? That, like, for most of this fight... What are you doing? Whoa! Okay, here we go. This is the last scan for this guy. Chicklings! Dark energy charge, Chykka offspring. Offspring form does not have parents' defenses. Evade if possible, engage if necessary. Okay, let me just... Bean around, 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 bean. I don't know. I think basically what all you want to do here is just try and damage it, and then once you've damaged it enough times, yeah, that actually like gets rid of the corruption. Let me see how much HP I'm at, because I'm a little bit nervous. Oh, I love right when the song is about to loop, it suddenly like dips into the right ear, like the stereo slides to the right, like on the last beat before the loop. Okay, we're fine. We don't need to worry about this at all. Yeah, I'm turning it back off. Live dangerous. Is that gonna be the name of this episode? Oh my god, I actually hit you? Wait, where are you? Well, that was maybe the most clumsy fucking seeker missile I think I've ever seen in my life. Oh man, how awesome would that have been if that had hit? Oh, dude, come on! Shit, get off the wall! Ha, ba boom! One more, yeah, yeah. Ha! Nice shot! Oh, I missed one. Well, I'm embarrassed then. Now make sure you jump when that thing lands, and then charge up your ice. Or not your ice beam, but your light beam. Oh, man. Oh, what? That's it? That's it? That's it? Are you kidding me? That was it? What a worthless excuse for an emperor. You didn't even make me use 1% of my power. Ooh, what's that? Here's an interesting upgrade, and an upgrade that's been a long time coming. Also, there's some pretty funny dialogue here if you scan the corpse. Bioscan complete. Target Chykka has been terminated. Life signs are at flatline. No regenerative ability in effect. No evidence of symbiotic corpse possession. Resurrection does not appear to be likely. Yeah, apparently Samus was just as sick of that thing as we were. What the heck is this thing? It's the Dark Visor! Yeah, about time we got a visor upgrade, huh? Make you wait until the end of World 2, halfway through the game, for your first visor. Or your first visor upgrade, I suppose. Because we already had the first TU visors. La 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 la. Now we have the Dark Visor, which is basically this game's version of the... Well, it kind of pulls double duty. Basically, this is like a dimensional visor, right? So it doesn't really see things. It doesn't sense things by thermal whatever, and it doesn't sense things by X-ray, you know, whatever. Instead, it senses things that are outside of the local time space. As you can see, there we go. And I'll turn the visor back on now, because we're actually missing out on some of the effects here by having that off. I'm probably not going to do that again. If enough people want to see... Well, actually, probably by the time this starts going up, I'll have the game recorded already. So people wouldn't be able to vote or, like, let me know if they want me to use that against a future boss. Because using that in the third major boss fight, now that could be interesting. That guy's kind of hard. Hugh. Huh. I find it curious that they don't really have... This game has very few, like, just... Well, I guess this is a random incidental track. I was just... I noticed, and I was slightly surprised to hear, like, the dark Torvus Bog music on the walk between the boss and the energy controller. You know, what you would normally think would be, like, a really triumphant, peaceful relief. You know, relieved moment. It has this, like, dark music playing over it, you know? It's very strange. And there you go. We have claimed the energy, or we have reclaimed the energy for Torvus Bog. Man, that boss fight is fun. I love that boss fight just because I love like jumping and grappling. I love, like, grappling and shooting and something, like, all before you touch the ground. I love stuff like that. If I could like hack Metroid Prime, I would make a boss that you fought entirely, like, over a toxic swamp with nothing but grapple points to carry you around. Like, how fun would that be? Like, a boss fight designed to be fought entirely while grappling around the arena without ever touching the ground. When it comes to satisfying stuff in games, I think stuff like that, where you can, like, platform for an extreme amount of time, or not even platform, but, like, you know, chain together movement combos to traverse huge areas without ever touching the ground is extremely satisfying. I heard an enemy. Apparently I'm hallucinating. Oh, my ammo was, like, totally fine. I can't believe it took me that long to realize that I was using the wrong beam against the Chykka larva. I mean, the thing is that, like, okay, you know, light side enemies are typically weak to the light beam, but that doesn't mean they resist the dark beam. Not to the degree that, like, the Ing, or that doesn't mean they resist the light beam. Not to the extent that dark creatures will resist the dark beam. Like, a dark creature will take almost no damage from the dark beam. But a light creature will still take, like, plenty of damage from the light beam, so it doesn't matter as much if you're using the wrong beam on a non-dark enemy. You know what I'm saying? How many different ways can I say the same thing? How many ways do I have to reiterate it before I can trust that everybody has adequately absorbed the information? Whee! Be funny if you could go through these portals as a ball, and it, like, showed you as a ball in that cutscene. That would be funny, because, like, theoretically there's like nothing stopping you from going through there. Whoa! Like, I didn't even notice the music stop. It just faded right back in neatly. I'm pretty sure I'm just imagining things, but it felt like it for a second there. I cannot sing those notes while sounding anything approaching decent. Because I have to go into falsetto to hit that top note. Oh, there's a missile expansion. That, like, morph ball tunnel we took in the last episode to get up to where the last key was. Here on the light side, there's actually a missile expansion in there, I think. There's some sort of expansion there. But you need power bombs to get in. So, we can't get in there yet. We'll just drop this off, and then I reckon we'll call it an episode. Assuming there's a nearby save point. There is a nearby save point, right? Sometimes I hate navigating the map for this area, because it's really easy to accidentally... Ugh. If I could finish a sentence without my body trying to burp, that'd be nice. I hate trying to navigate the map for Torvis Bog because of the lower Torvis Bog. Like, it, like, overlaps at so many angles. Alright. Man, oh my god, the dark suit... Like, it looks like Samus is wearing a diaper when you look at her from behind. Like, the pelvis piece of the dark suit armor is so... It's so big in the back, but it's so thin that it doesn't cover her whole... Like, if it covered her whole ass, it'd just look like she had a big ass. But it's so thin that it looks like she's wearing a diaper. It's like, man... And it's gonna be a long time before we get another suit. Our next suit upgrade. There is one more suit upgrade. This game only has two suits. And you get them like pretty much. You get them at like 25% and 85% of the way through the game. So you spend like most of the game in like the comparatively chunky, inelegant dark suit. You know. Not that the dark suit looks bad or anything, I just think it's probably the least appealing of the three suits in this game because of small idiosyncrasies. Like how weird the shoulders look. Like the shoulders look weird, and when you're in a morph ball, you're not very round. You look like a little dreidel, like a really round, fat dreidel. Oh man, that green is so nice. Emerald! What was I thinking? Let me get you some rubies! Da-ba-da-da. Oh man, that was really bad. I could feel myself warbling on and off the note. On and off the register. You know, because the Koopa behind the counter is like, no, but if you would like to register. You up. Oh my god, I'm so... Oh, man. Oh man, that cough. I felt... I don't know how to describe it. I don't want to say I felt blood in that cough, but I felt like... You know when you cough, like, when you cough hard and you feel like the blood rush to your face from how hard you're... from like, the cough? It doesn't even need to be, like, an especially hard cough. It's just, like, certain brands of coughs create these, like... Oh, fuck off. Oh, these guys, actually. Okay. This is worth noting. The Dark Visor can bypass these guys' camouflage. And it only takes, like, a few light beam shots to kill them. So there you go. They ain't so tough after all. Oh, hi. Jeez, man. Yeah. So that comes in very handy. Thankfully, we will not have to be dealing. We will not have to deal with those guys anymore after this area. I mean, we're gonna have to come back here for. Did I already read this? I think I already read this. I had to like play back to where I was at one point, and I think I forgot to pick that up. Well, no, hang on, I didn't. Did I? I don't fucking remember. I'm trying to find a save point, man. I'm up to 30 minutes here. I'm kind of running out of disk space on this computer, so you know. If we could keep the episodes a little bit shorter, I wouldn't mind that. Ugh, suck my... Yo! No! Save point. Deliver me from Grinchlers. Okay. That's gonna do it for me. Next time on Metroid Prime 2... We will head back for the Great Temple, meet up with Yumos, and be directed to our next destination. Look forward to it, because I know I am. That area is really, really cool and really, really dangerous. You can see me smiling as I got him.